Last week I made a video about what charisma is and how to train it. And one of my main advices was go out and interact with people. And a question that I got from quite some people, especially on Reddit, was, but where do I have to meet new people? And that is the question that I'm going to answer today. How to make friends and where to find them. Welcome to Brains Applied. Remember that if you like this video and you want to see more videos like this in the future, press the subscribe button and the bell icon so you receive a notification next Friday when I upload a new movie. I will love you if you do so and your mom will give you a cookie. Before I start ranting about how to make friends, I first want to talk about what friendship exactly is and where it comes from. You might have heard of this idea of chemistry between two people, meaning a sexual relationship-ish tension, and this also exists for friendship. Some recent research has found that friendship chemistry mostly consists out of five factors. These five factors make up about 56% of the variance in friendship chemistry. The first one is physical attractiveness. Now, you might be like, we're just friends, that's kinda weird. But this actually is true. If you see someone of who you think that he is really, really hideous, you are less likely to go talk to him. And I guess you guys all know this feeling when you see a person for the first time and you just think, this person has a really, really, really punchable face. That, on average, is not very good for growing your friendship. Number two is similarity. This is similarity in your life in general. For example, education, but also your values and morals that you have been raised with, or for example, your life goals. If you want to become a rich, career-driven guy and your friend wants to become a pig farmer somewhere in the middle of nowhere, you are less likely to become friends. Number three is mutual interests. This aspect goes for humor as well as interests in general. For example, let's say you both like ice hockey or playing Dungeons and Dragons. The similar interest means that you actually have something to talk about, and this is, of course, very good if you want to grow a friendship. Number four is personableness. The state or quality of having a pleasurable or agreeable manner in socializing with others. If you express a certain kindness and warmth in your relationship, you will be more likable towards other people. So just be nice and smile. The last aspect is reciprocal candor. If you don't know what reciprocal candor means, don't worry, I had to look it up myself as well. It means having some kind of understanding, some kind of trust, having this connection, you know. You probably have all met this one person in your life of who you thought, I like this person, I just met him, but he understands me and I like him. And that is what reciprocal candor is. The next question is where and how to meet new people. Before I start off this part, I just want to mention that you have to keep in mind cultural differences. For example, I'm in Denmark right now on exchange, and if you want to get to know Danish people, you really need to take them to a bar and you have to take some drinks with them. Honestly, if like alcohol would not exist in Denmark, relationships and romance would be dead as well. And it's even worse in Norway, where you have to like keep 10 meters distance to the next person to be socially acceptable. And other cultures are like way, way, way more open. It's completely different in different cultures. My advice for you guys was to get out of your door. And most important here is that you actually find something that you like to do. Don't go partying in some club if you don't like it. You will have a shit evening and the people that you meet won't be your type of people either. Find some clubs, some associations, take some workshops. Do you like cooking? Take some cooking workshop. Do you like dancing? Take some salsa classes. Do you like book reading? Join a book club. Or if you like esports, join an esports team. There is so much out there that you can do. Just use Google, ask a friend or someone else, or look on Facebook. You can also check Facebook for events at which you can volunteer. Most events that work with volunteers are always looking for more people. You can help out at a concert or a marathon, and the people that are helping over there probably have some shared interest with you. And this is great if you want to get some bonding done. You can also ask someone who you already know but not that well to do something. There might be a colleague at work who would love getting a coffee with you. There might be a guy in your class who would love to get a beer with you. And if it turns out that you actually like them, invite them more often, because friendship, especially in the beginning, needs a repeated interaction. You need to see them more often. And if someone invites you to do something, don't be like, I don't know if I can do this. Be positive. Yes, I would love to go there. I have to check my agenda, but I would like to go there with you. And try to get there. There is something called the mere exposure effect, and it states that if people are exposed to you more often, they will start to like you more. Last but not least, follow the tips of my charisma video. Smile, be genuinely interested, put away your smartphone, and ask questions. Don't overdo that though, because it becomes kind of weird if you only ask questions. Tell something about yourself as well. And be nice to other people and also about other people. There is this psychological phenomenon called the spontaneous trait reference, and it states that if you say something good or bad about other people, people will automatically start attributing this trait to you as well, and this is something which you might want to avoid. Last but not least, be patient. Growing friendships takes time, and if you would like to have some feedback or advice, just ask someone. The social skills subreddit tends to be a really good place for this. And if you get rejected, pay attention to how you interpret it. As I've mentioned in one of my older videos, your previous experiences have a major influence on the way you think and on how you perceive new experiences. If you've been bullied before, you will be way faster at interpreting something in a bad way. And the truth is that being rejected is just not always your fault. And honestly, would you like to be friends with someone who doesn't really care about you in the first place? But I think that you guys can do this, and that's what I wanted to tell you today. If you liked this video, I hope you did, press the like button. And if you have some topic that you want to see me talk about in the future, or if you have some questions, just drop a comment below. Most importantly, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and to press the notification bell so you receive a notification next Friday when I upload a new video. And I will see you guys later.